Hey everyone, this is Pastor Harold, and I want to share a couple of thoughts with you and also give some information for the First Baptist West Church family. You know, we're living in some strange and difficult times and uncharted territory that none of us have ever gone through before. And I know we have an adversary who's trying to disrupt and discourage everyone, but especially the church. And we at First Baptist West, we're not exempt to that. So as you know, we are under a state of emergency where we've been encouraged to have no gatherings of 50 or more people at any time. And we're going to honor that request. And we're not going to gather in our building for worship or any activities until at least April the 6th. Now, we're not going to count this as a time off, but we can't actually count this as an amazing time for the church and to reach people for Jesus. And we're going to do this in a couple of ways. The first one is we're going to call on our small group leaders to give contact all of your people on your roster in your class and at least give them the information for the scripture and the lesson that you're going to be teaching that Sunday morning. But we're also going to have another way that we're going to have a video conference that you and your class could use. And if you'll go to the description to the website below, there'll be more information given to how you can do that. Or you can even call our church office and we can get you together on how to have a video conference with your own Sunday school class. But then after that, what we're wanting to try to have everyone do is all throughout the church, and even if you have a church that where maybe your church can't do live stream, we want to encourage you to join with us at 10:45 on Sunday morning, and we're going to be having a great live stream service. We're going to have a full-scale service here at First Baptist West that we're going to send out to the live stream since no one can be in here with us. The second way that we're going to do it is that we're going to have our deacons and our leaders be in contact with all of your people on your family list, on your class roster. And what I'm going to ask you to do is make at least contact with them at least two times each week to find out some things that they may be needing. Maybe they're not being able to get out like you can. But we wanted to make sure that we're taking really good care of them. So contact those people. We're going to have a great opportunity to minister to everyone. You know, this could be an amazing time for the church. As a matter of fact, I'm reminded of the book of Genesis chapter 50, where Joseph was talking to his brothers after he had been sold into slavery by them, and he had gone into prison, and so many different things had gone on into his life, and he was standing before them. And what he told them was, he said, "Guys, you meant this for evil for me, but God turned it to good, for good to accomplish a day like this." And my friends, Satan wants this to be a bad time for us. And he wants to do everything he can to make it that way. But God can turn this into something really good. And I believe if we'll stay faithful and honor him and support each other and worship together, that we're going to have a great time in our church. You know, again, this is not a time off. This is not a time for us to step back. But it's a time for us to take everything that we've done for preparation through prayers and Bible studies and worship and all those great things that we've been doing as a church to prepare us for a time like this. So as I've told my church this past Sunday, folks, it's game time now for the church. It's time for us to minister to reach people for Jesus. And I want to encourage you that if you have any needs, anything that we can possibly help you with, please contact us here at First Baptist West. We want to help you in any way that we can. Now, we have had people asking throughout this time that we're not going to be meeting and gathering and not taking up offerings, how can they give to the church? Well, the first way that you can give is go by online giving. You can go to our webpage, and there's a section there where you can give your tithes and offerings. The second one is you can mail it to us, or you can drop it by and drop it in the mailbox if it's after hours, because our mailbox is secure and you can drop it in there. Or you can even bring it by the office, and that way we can visit with you and try to encourage you. But as I said, these are difficult times. They're strange times. We're trying to navigate the best way we can. But all I do know is that God is in control, and he's going to bless us, and this can be some great times. For a great time for the church in reaching people for Jesus. I want to thank you for taking some time just to watch this video. And again, know that we love you, and that if you need anything, contact us. God bless you, and we're going to get through this, I promise.